When you have to ride a quattro velo on a snowy road, you will quickly notice it doesn't feel very stable.
I have no control of this velomobile anymore. Yeah, the rear end is sliding around.
Also, the velomobile seems to be going all over the place. It feels pretty wobbly to ride.
Holy shit. Again, I'm losing traction at the rear.
Now, let's find out what's going on at the rear end of the quattro velo and why it feels so unstable. Let's start on this kind of snowy combined pedestrian way / cycle path. There's few centimeters of snow with a lot of footmarks and bike tire tracks. The velomobile usually feels quite wobbly to ride on path in this condition. Now let's try to see what the rear wheels are doing. Here the right wheel goes over some small bumps on the snow. The quattro velo has rigid rear axle, so if one wheel hits a bump like this, the angle or camber of the other wheel will change as well. And because this has relatively narrow track width, the camber of the another wheel changes relatively much, as you can see here. And looks like the pivot point of the axle is high. This means that when the axle tilts like this, the part of the wheel touching the ground also has to move sideways in relation to the body. Also, the relatively short panhard rod causes the axle to move sideways at the ends of the suspension travel. So all this movement makes the rear end of the quattro velo to feel very lively and unstable, even though it might actually be under control all the time. But there must be something more going on as well. Let's try this small downhill where I have had some control problems before. This road has hard packed snow with a lot of car tire tracks, making the hard snow surface very bumpy. Here we can see that when traveling at high speed on this kind of uneven surface, the suspension is doing quite a lot of work. Here we can see that the wheel is trying to bounce from the ground when it rolls over some bumps. Because the rear axle assembly is relatively heavy, it has quite much of unsprung mass. This means that the wheel tends to bounce from the ground on bumpy surface, as we can see here. And when the wheel bounces, it will lose grip, which will make the handling more difficult. This, of course, gets worse when the speed is higher, like for example on this small downhill. Less unsprung mass would help to keep the wheel on the ground, and thus would give better grip. I guess you could improve the grip and handling by using more stiffer dampers. That would probably reduce the wheel bounce. But anyway, I think there's still few more things affecting the handling in winter. First, these relatively narrow 40mm tires. These tend to find all the grooves and holes on the snow, and that causes the ride to feel quite unstable. Also, when there's some loose snow on the ground, it tends to feel even worse. This, by the way, affects both the rear wheels and the front wheels. White tires would probably be less sensitive to the uneven surface of a snowy road and thus solve the problem. But there's no room for fat tires on quattro velo, and also there's very limited selection of winter tires in this size. As far as I know, you are basically limited to only two options, both about 40 mils wide. Then there's the narrower track width of the rear axle, causing the quattro to make four lines on the snow. I wasn't sure if this would affect the stability and handling, because the front and rear wheels are traveling far enough from each other's tracks. But then I saw this footage. Here we can clearly see how the rear wheel comes very close to the track of the front wheel. That might very well cause the rear wheel to fall into that track, because that's what these narrow tires tend to do. This must be the reason why the stability feels even worse when there's some snow on the road. Because of all these things, you usually don't want to go too fast in winter conditions. The 25 km/h speed limit of my electric assist system is actually plenty fast on snowy roads like these. And sometimes it might even feel too fast. But anyway, all this is only problem in winter. In summer, on regular asphalt roads, which may or may not be in good condition, I usually have no issues with the rear suspension or any of these things. In fact, the quattro velo is very comfortable to ride, and the rear suspension seems to work very well in summer conditions. But it's not perfect. Sometimes at high speeds, the handling feels somehow unstable. There are also other minor things which I've complained about in this another video. So go watch that one next and see you there. Bye.